Mrs. Fuss is back again today with a new story. As we all know, festive season is in the air. And today's tale is about Raksha Bandhan. Yes, Raksha Bandhan. Tell me, what do you think when Raksha Bandhan comes to your mind? I'm sure you're thinking about chocolates, gifts. Well, that's really nice. But Raksha Bandhan has a story behind it. A sister ties Rakhi on the brother's wrist when brother promises the sister that he's always going to protect her. So, who tied the first Rakhi still remains a mystery. But let's quickly begin with our Raksha Bandhan tale. But before we start the story, let's sing our lines which we always sing together. Are you all ready? A pinch of hope, a punch of love, and magic smoke. Stir in some fun. Are you stirring? Stir in some fun. The magic pot is ready to cook some stories dreamy. The magic pot is ready to cook some stories dreamy. Abracadabra, zooby dooby dot. Let's cook some stories in the magic pot. It's always very beautiful, isn't it? Where we dress up in new clothes and we get all good things to eat. But why do we celebrate these festivals? There is always a tale or a mystery behind it. So today we are here to talk about Raksha Bandhan. Can you see this? It's my beautiful thali which I have decorated for my brother. This is my Rakhi which I am going to tie for my brother. And this is one more Rakhi which I am going to tie on my brother's wife's hand. Yes, so today times have changed. But let's stick to history. And one beautiful tale is coming to my mind. Well, who tied the first Rakhi remains a mystery. But let's start quickly with the history. It's about Lord Ganesha. Yes, we are going to have him very soon in all our houses. So Lord Ganesha one day got up very early. He dressed up in best of his clothes and he was extremely happy that day. His children, yes, Shubh and Lab, they started looking at their father and started wondering, what is so special today? Is it somebody's birthday? That father looks so excited and happy? Or are we going out somewhere? But they waited. When Ganesha was all ready and they saw him looking at the door again and again and waiting for somebody, they approached their father and asked their father, "Father, what is so special today? You look extremely happy. You dressed up in beautiful clothes. Mummy is cooking all delicious food in the kitchen. Are we expecting somebody special?" So Ganesha smiled and said, "You must wait. You must wait and watch. You will know this very soon." So his children also sat waiting for something to happen. When they saw their aunt Mansa walking in, and Mansa was also dressed up in a beautiful red sari, even she was looking very happy and excited. And then Mansa came to Lord Ganesha and she tied a beautiful Rakhi on his wrist. And Ganesha blessed her and gave her lots of gifts. So these children, they asked their father, "Father, what is so special? Why is she tying this beautiful Rakhi on your hand and you showering her with gifts?" And then Ganesha explained them that on the 15th day of Shravan is a full moon day. And this day we celebrate Raksha Bandhan, when every sister comes and ties Rakhi on the brother's wrist. And the brother showers the sister with lot of gifts and love and affection. And he also promises the sister that he is always going to be there to protect her. So this is a band of protection, maybe a promise. The children were very, very excited and happy. But soon they started wondering, what about us? We want a sister too. Even we want to celebrate Raksha Bandhan. When they insisted, Lord Ganesha actually blessed them with a sister that day. And do we know who's this sister? Yes, it is goddess Santoshi Ma. Santoshi Ma, yes. Santoshi Ma is a sister to Shubh and Lav. So this is how the ritual started. I also remember one more tale which I'm definitely going to share with you, because we are going to have Janmashtami soon. Yes, it is about Lord Krishna and his sister. So are you all ready for one more story? Okay, let's quickly start. One day, on the auspicious occasion of Makar Sankranti, Lord Krishna was flying kites and enjoying sugarcane. Isn't sugarcane yummy? Yes, he was enjoying sugarcane. When accidentally, he chipped his finger. His finger started bleeding. And when everybody around saw that, oh, Lord Krishna's finger is bleeding, they got very restless. Everybody was trying to source out something or the other which would help Krishna to stop the bleeding from his finger. Draupadi was standing next to Krishna, and when she saw everybody is running around looking for something, maybe a bandage or something, she quickly took her sari and she tore the sari. Yes, she tore her new sari and she wrapped that around his little finger. Immediately his finger stopped bleeding. Lord Krishna was very emotional and he got very happy when Draupadi showed this gesture. And he promised Draupadi that he would always be there to protect her. Well, we all know what happened in Mahabharata, right? When Draupadi was actually disrobed. Yes, when everybody was sitting in the palace, Lord Krishna fulfilled his word and he was there to help her. And there was some magic which was created. And it seemed that Draupadi's sari, you know, it extended. It kept extending and extending till they were pulling her sari. And he protected her and did not allow anybody to disrobe her in front of everybody in the kingdom. So this is a beautiful tale of a brother and sister. So this year when you celebrate Raksha Bandhan, remember sisters are very special. They always shower you with lot of love and affection. And this is all they ask, that they expect all the brothers to be always be with them in the time of trouble. So hope you have a wonderful Raksha Bandhan. See you. Bye.